We are going to discuss another PLC application, that is our wagon control problem application. So now let us go for the problem description at first. A wagon is driven by cable going from A to B. A is the one place and B is another place. So station A to station B, and from B to A back again, and stops automatically when it reaches end A or B of the track. So a wagon will be moving from station A to station B, and then again it will return back from station B to station A. When the wagon is at A, the operator presses the push button PB1. So that is one push button which will indicate that start of the journey of the wagon. The wagon starts towards B and stops automatically after reaching at the station B. The wagon restarts automatically from B to A back again, depending on the decision of the operator. So from B to A, it can come down in two different modes, mode number 1 and mode number 2. Either immediately, there is a mode number 1, after reaching B, it will come back to A immediately, or after a certain stipulated amount of delay, so let it be 5 seconds, and only when the operator has already pressed the PB2, that is another push button. After returning back, the wagon stops automatically at station A. When the wagon is in operation, a safety lamp will glow, will indicate that the operation is now on. So this is the basic description of our application. So this is one wagon, that is our terminal A or station A. This is our terminal B or station B. So this is the layout diagram. Here we are having two push buttons. One is a start push button and another one is the delay mode selector push button. So here these are the inputs we are having, that is the start, limit sensor A, limit sensor B, delay mode changer, that is the push button. And we are having three outputs, that is the motor which will make the wagon move from A to B, another motor from B to A, and then safety lamp indicator. So that will be also the output of this PLC application. Okay, now this is the respective PLC wiring diagram. I am proposing this diagram, but obviously this diagram will get changed depending upon the PLC model and mech, and obviously with the depending upon the accessories getting installed along with this application. So here we are having this output terminals we are having. So one is the limit sensor A, that is the limit sensor B. So these are my inputs rather, limit sensor A, limit sensor B, and here we are having this respective start push button and also the delay selector push button. So these are the respective inputs we are having. Okay, now this is the output section. So in this output section we have got this motor connected through this interposing relay which will move the wagon from limit A to limit B. This is another motor which will, with the help of which it will come back, and that is the safety lamp. So here we are having this 1, 2, 3, 4 inputs, and here we are having 2 outputs accordingly, 2 or 3 outputs accordingly. Okay. So now how the respective ladder diagram can be formed. So this is a ladder diagram of this wagon control problem. So when the push button is pressed, that is the start push button has been pressed, and when the wagon is at the sensor A, until it reaches to sensor B, that is the limit B, the wagon will be in operation. So motor which will carry the wagon from A to B will be on, and that is a parallel path, latch path is here, and which is bypassing these two, because you know that when the push button will be released, then it will not remain on, and when the wagon will be in between station A and station B, then limit sensor A cannot sense the wagon. So that's why there is one path, so that the wagon will be in motion until it reaches to station B. So now the next one, that is operator has selected the delay switch, the delay mode. So on delay timer until on, this M1 will indicate that the delay mode has got selected by the operator. So that is one latch here, because it is nothing but a push button. So now when M1 is on, that means when the delay switch, delay mode is on, and until it reaches, and when it is at the station B, so when it is reaching and reached at the station B, then this on delay timer will be on. So when these two are simultaneously on, then only the on delay timer will be on, and here the parameter has been set as say 5 seconds. So now when this particular wagon will return back from B to A, what are the two modes? So mode number one is that when the on delay timer is on and until it reaches to this limit A, that means the reaching to the source from where it is begin its journey, and this is the limit A, and this motor from B to A will be in operation. Otherwise, when the mode has not been selected, that is the delay mode has not been selected, and it is at the limit switch B, then the return journey can be initiated. And this is a parallel path, so that when they will get off the parallel path, through the parallel path, the return journey can be continued with this particular motor, that is motor moving the wagon from B to A. And this is the respective outputs, and all these things will be doing the testing in the simulation mode in our practical demonstration. So after watching this ladder diagram, whatever I have proposed, you can do the experiments at your end, and you can get it cross verified, and through this demonstration, practical demonstration, which I'm going to do right now. Please watch our practical demonstration on this wagon control problem. In this session, we shall discuss the ladder diagram for wagon control problem, and also we shall simulate the circuit, simulate the ladder diagram for the testing. Okay, now at first I want to show you that what are the input and output labeling I have done. So I1 is move push button, also you can call it as a start push button. So here in the simulation I shall have to make it momentarily make. I2 is the limit sensor A, I3 is the limit sensor B, I4 is the mode selector for the delay. Next, Q1 is the motor which will be helping the wagon to move from point A to point B, and Q2 is for the motor which will enable the wagon to move from point B to point A. So these are the labels we have done. So I need not to increase the page layout size because it has got confined within one page. Now this is I1, so we have made this one in the simulation mode. We have made this one as momentary push button make, put some comment. So this is my move push button, and another one is our delay selector for mode selector for delay. So we are going for this, and here also it is momentarily push button make, momentary push button make, and having some comment. I can put some comment if I require. So here in the labeling we did the remark accordingly. We did the labeling accordingly. Okay, now this is our timer. This is the timer which will wait for 5 seconds. So now let me discuss this ladder diagram at first. So let us suppose I want to make this Q1 on. That means the wagon will move from point A to point B. Now when this wagon will move from point A to point B, when the start the operation button, push button will be pressed, and initially the wagon is at the sensor A, limit A. So limit sensor A is detecting the wagon, and until and unless the wagon has reached to the limit sensor B. So you know that when this motor will be on, then the wagon will leave the limit sensor A, and as it is a push button, so it will be going off. So that's why we are providing one parallel path here, one latch here. That means if it is on, if this logic can make this Q1 on, then Q1 will remain on until limit sensor is detecting that the wagon has reached there. So this is the wagon move from A to B. Now when we can select that the mode selector, that is the delay mode, has been selected. So if the delay mode selector button has been pressed, it is a push button, and the timer is not on, then this mode selector will be enabled. And here we are having, because it is a push button, so obviously after pressing this one it will get released. So to have a latch here, so that if M1 is on, due to this logic, it is yes and it is no, it is true and for it is false, then M1 will be on, and then we are having a parallel latch here, so that M1 will be on, will remain on
irrespective of the factor that I4 has gone down or not, gone off or not. Okay, now this is my timer. So when the M1 mode is selected, that is the delay mode, and my wagon is at the limit sensor B, so wagon is at B, then this timer will be on. Now when the timer will be on, the timer will be on after 5 seconds because the delay is accordingly. And when the 5 seconds, after the 5 seconds when the timer will be on, then that will cut this line and obviously this M1 will go low. So now when B2A movement will take place, when timer will be on and this limit sensor, until the limit sensor A is sensed. So timer will be on after 5 seconds. So after 5 seconds, move to B2A, move B2A will be initiated. And otherwise, the operator has selected the delay mode, has not selected the delay mode because it is the brake contact, and limit sensor B is being sensed. That means the wagon is at limit sensor B. So when the timer, when the delay mode has not been selected, and then when the wagon will be at sensor B, so immediately move B2A will be initiated. So now you see that it will leave this limit sensor B when the wagon will be moving from B to A. So that's why here we are providing one alternate path, parallel path, one latching has been done, so that when the B to A will be initiated, then it will remain initiated, it will remain on until the wagon reaches to limit sensor A. So that is the total description of the ladder diagram. So let me go for the simulation at first. So this is our simulation. Here I1 is denoting the start push button. This I2 is the sensor A, I3 we have discussed, it is sensor B, and I4 is the delay mode. And this M1 is the, when the delay mode will be on. And this Q1 it means the motor is moving from A to B, and Q2 means the motor is moving from B to A. And here this M1 is denoting the delay mode selection. So let us suppose my wagon is at A and the delay mode has not been selected. So now I'm pressing this I1, and here you see motor, that means which will move the wagon from A to B, has been initiated. So when it will leave sensor A, so it will be off, and then also the motor is in continuation. So that means the wagon is moving from A to B until it reaches to, that is the limit B. So when the limit B has been reached, then immediately, because I didn't select this delay mode, immediately the return motor, that means wagon is now moving from B to A, has been initiated. So it will leave this sensor B, then also the motor is moving from B to A, wagon is moving from B to A, due to this fact the motor is on until it reaches to our limit A. So in this way the one cycle has been completed. Now let me test the same ladder diagram using the delay mode. So now you see I have made the delay mode on. So now when I shall make this start push button, so Q1 is on, so it is leaving limit A. Now it has got this limit B. Now here you see this counter is being is on the way, timer is in the on way. So after 5 seconds this Q2 has become on. So now it is leaving this sensor B, it is coming to sensor A, and Q2 is off. Again I'm pressing this delay, pressing this one start, it is moving, it has been released, it has been taken. So now this timer is working. So after 5 seconds this Q2 is on, it is leaving this sensor B and coming to sensor A, and cycle has got completed. So in this way our circuit has got tested thoroughly. So I'm scrolling very slowly, just see that what are the different rungs are there in this ladder diagram, and at your end try to design the same ladder diagram, or you can use your own logic to design the same ladder diagram and go for testing accordingly in the simulation mode. Leave your comments and doubts, your difficulties, your issues, please share them with us through the comment block, and we shall do the needful communication. And thanks for watching this video.